Sharing truths in an honest and safe space where everyone can speak up and say exactly what's on their mind has been one of my priorities. And on this show, I have welcomed and nurtured self-love by showing new perspectives and self-care tips from people who have invested so much into putting themselves first that they have no time for hate and self-doubt. These are their stories of change, inspiration, and everything in between. And I hope that talking about it helps you realize that everything you want is on the other side of your insecurities and fears. So join in on the conversation. This is The Talk with Tricia Centenaro. What I want to know is what you define self-love and self-care to be, because it's so different to everybody else.
It is. You know, self-care and self-love would have to be finding things that I like, finding time to do things that I like to do, mm-hmm. which would be like, I was telling you this earlier, like working out is what I enjoy. Working out is my version of self-love. So like finding time to work out, and because I just feel better afterwards. And I don't know, doing things that make me happy. But then again, I'm really simple. So since I'm so babaw, like what makes me happy is just lighting incense sometimes at home, and then having a good cup of coffee. And to me, that's like self-care. Reading a good book. Mm-hmm. And self-love would be appreciating and having appreciating every blessing that comes into my mm-hmm. life. And just being really grateful and taking time to acknowledge like all the good things in my life, because I think we don't stop. We're always like on the go, but then taking time to reflect and be thankful, mm-hmm. that makes me like love myself more, love life more, and appreciate everyone around me.
I mean, you have such a busy schedule from taping. You just said that you finished doing a show. How do you, you said that you stop, you exercise, you say thankful, you're grateful for everything, but are there things that you do at home with your husband that is that extra step further, especially because you're so busy?
It would have to be just like watch a good movie and eat at home. But you know, it's actually harder than it sounds, because sometimes we can't agree on like a movie to watch.
Which one to watch?
Yeah, it's like we're just scrolling like the whole time looking for a movie to watch, because we're so opposite. Like he likes like the action movies and like all the like, you know, guy stuff. I like watching like documentaries or whatever, so he gets bored. So he's the one who like nahihiya siya. Like mm-hmm. He's like, I'm so sorry, but I can't. Like, yes. I can't do this. So I'll be the one to watch on my phone, you know? And also because like I sleep earlier than him. So mm-hmm. until like early in the morning, he's just like watching.
So you wake up in the morning, have coffee. Is there some kind of routine that you do? Do you have any kind of skincare routine that you do every day when you wake up?
Yeah, I do. Like before I leave the house, I like to put ice on my face. Just, you know, for the pores and the puffiness, because sometimes like we're bloated, it helps a lot. Yeah. And my eye bags. And then when I come home, I take off my makeup with coconut oil. Mm-hmm. So I know you're telling me about like, you know, the organic, your mm-hmm. like your mm-hmm. label as well.
Yeah.
So like the organic scrubs. Yeah. And I don't think that you have to spend a lot of money to have good products. Like they're available everywhere.
Mm-hmm. In the industry here in the Philippines, is there anybody who you kind of look up to when it comes to self-care and self-love?
I do look up to Lovey, when it comes to her discipline and taking care of her body.
Yeah,
because she's crazy. I worked with her for like two shows, mm-hmm. so I was with her for like 2 years almost, and she works out, everyone knows, she works out like crazy, and then she's very like particular with what she eats.
Okay.
She always has like these green shakes, green mm-hmm. smoothies, and like I can do that, but just for to an extent.
Right.
I'm not like addicted to it, mm-hmm. and I'm not like OC about it, but she's like crazy in a good way.
Yeah,
I respect that. So I do look up to her in terms of her discipline mm-hmm. and and any athlete in general, because right. like she's almost an athlete. So like all athletes really have to have very good discipline, mm-hmm. right? And mm-hmm. and my husband also, because he makes it a point to work out every single day, sweat every day, but he doesn't diet, so he just eats whatever.
So when you're going through social media, I also find it interesting to see what different people say, because when I see an account that makes me feel bad, I will unfollow.
Oh yeah?
Right? So, okay. I mean, I think that I want to surround myself with like-minded people. Like even you were saying that you look up to or you get inspired by Lovey. When it comes to social media, do you see certain things that you kind of just don't really like and will unfollow?
Probably not unfollow, maybe just because it's become like a TV to me, so I just like, unfollow okay. would be like maybe if there are like too many naked photos. You know how some people yes. love posting naked photos mm-hmm. all the time? So it's like, if I see like way too many, then I'll just unfollow because okay. it gets annoying.
Okay.
But then like, do you mean what makes me feel bad, like insecure?
Yeah.
Okay, so like insecure would be, it happens all the time, I guess, right? Like mm-hmm. you just see like, okay, people traveling, especially people traveling, people like having the best experience.
Right.
Like it, even like couples, like it's just, it's just become this aspirational thing where like everybody, you always want to be more. Mm-hmm. You're never happy with what you see. Mm-hmm. So I guess I feel bad all the time when I look at Instagram. Now that I think about it, it's like a very unhealthy.
Right.
But then again, you know, it's not real.
Okay. So that's how you deal with it. But you know what? It sounds like that you seem to be very unfazed by it all. You seem to have a very good. Image of self-worth. Were there times with you in your career where you felt insecure about certain things, about your body, about how you looked?
Always, yeah. It always, until now. Mm-hmm. What has helped me throughout the years is that you really won't last in this industry if you're soft.
Right.
You have to be really tough. Mm-hmm. And you can do everything to change, but there will still be people that don't like you.
Yeah.
So it's like, what would make you happy?
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's what, now that I'm older, I ask myself that question, mm-hmm. what would make me happy versus what would make other people happy?
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, you'll never be perfect. So just mm-hmm. be tired, like mm-hmm. trying to get there, right? So mm-hmm. I guess it comes with age.
I think what you said was perfect. You said, it's okay. There are gonna be some people who aren't gonna be okay with you. You need to be okay with yourself.
Yeah.
You know, knowing who you are, knowing what you want, knowing where you're going. It's all about self-awareness, right? What advice would you give other girls who are maybe going through some kind of insecurity in their life and they're not really dealing with it well?
It would probably, like, knowing that it will pass.
Yeah.
You know, like acne and weight gain and mm-hmm. all of those things, they will all pass.
Mm-hmm.
Like there's always a way to get out of it. But then the problem is when we're younger, we dwell on those things.
Yeah.
We're like, I'm so fat, or I'm so unhealthy, or I'm so ugly. But it's like, there's a way to bring out the best in you that doesn't have to be like through surgery,
mm-hmm.
that doesn't have to be so drastic,
mm-hmm.
you know, but then it could be as simple as doing a good workout and feeling, hey, I'm strong.
Mm-hmm.
Like I can, in a few months, I'll have abs. You know,
right.
I mean, you just have to take it day by day, step mm-hmm. by step.
Okay, so I ask all of my guests to bring something in. What did you bring in? It can be something sentimental,
yeah,
or
yeah.
it could be something that you carry around with you every single day that you never leave home
yeah.
without.
Yeah, I really thought about it last night. I'm like, what would be my fake answer and what would be my real answer? I'm like, I really don't.
Did you go with your real
answer? I went with my real answer, sadly, so I'm so sorry. But like, I never leave my house without my like my backpack with this is all my workout stuff.
Okay.
So I need to get in a workout every single day. Almost. Yeah.
When you get your workouts in, is it whenever you can, wherever you are, you know where there's a gym class, a Pilates class, a boxing yeah. class?
Yeah, I have to like, even if I don't have like a set schedule in mind, I'll bring it anyway,
okay.
just in case I can squeeze it in.
Okay.
So like even if I'm taping, maybe there's a gym nearby, maybe I can like segue a workout.
Okay.
But yeah, I have all like my gym stuff
this
in
is your
here.
Gym bag.
Yeah, it's my gym bag. So it's very, it's actually my husband.
So you never leave home without?
Never leave home without. Never. I mean, the bag varies, but yeah, it has to be like a big bag.
Okay.
And so I never leave home without it.
And what else? Did you bring something else?
Well, like you asked for something sentimental that I bring. It's my wedding ring, obviously. But then I know a lot of actors who, well, I also do this sometimes. But like sometimes we take off our rings, we leave it at home. Because like when we're taping.
You don't want to lose it.
Yeah, we don't want to lose it. And also because like if we're not married in the show, then, you know, we can't wear our rings. But I always bring it with me and then I'll have like my assistant wear it.
Okay.
Something. And so it's obviously sentimental.
How long have you been married for?
Since 2017. So my husband's name is inside with our wedding date.
Nice.
I've been trying to practice minimalism. So I don't like holding on to because I used to move a lot when I was younger. So I learned to like pack light and not to hold on to things. Mm-hmm. So I don't really keep any like sentimental items, you know,
like less is more.
Less is more. Okay. Yeah, definitely.
Oh, nice. Well, thank you so much for coming today.
Thank you so much for having me.
Wow, Tricia. You've definitely been a very different interview.
Oh, cool.
As I said, I thought. Yes. I was expecting. I don't know. I was expecting you to answer the questions a little bit differently, in a sense that, you know, you do all the things that. I mean, I suppose people say, oh, you shouldn't do this, you shouldn't be on social media too much, you shouldn't listen too much to what other people say. But it seems that you listen to everything that is around you, but you just are able to siphon through it really well. You put into the rubbish what you need to put in the rubbish, you take on board what you need to take on board, and it's made you who you are. It's made you strong.
Thank you.
Anyway, well, thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
I will definitely see you soon.
Thank you. Bye. I'm going to take my bag.
Take your bag and go to my workout.
Yeah, literally.